Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Today, as we celebrate our achievements, we gratefully acknowledge God's providence and love. In this Eucharistic celebration, we offer to God, in gratitude, our achievements. We also thank God for our parents, siblings, relatives, friends, our school administrators, teachers, and everyone who has supported and helped us reach this point in our lives. Filled with gratitude then, let us begin our celebration by asking our loving Father to pardon our sins. I confess,
O my God, and you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do. Through my fault, therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
For to you I have entrusted my cause.
Sing to the Lord, praise the Lord, for he has rescued the life of the poor from the power of the wicked. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Answered them, I have shown you many good works from my Father. For which of these are you trying to stone me? The Jews answered him, We are not stoning you for a good work, but for blasphemy. You, a man, are making yourself God. Jesus answered them, Is it not written in your law? I said, You are gods. If it calls them gods, to whom the word of God came, and scripture cannot be set aside, can you say that the one whom the Father has consecrated and sent into the world blasphemes because I said, I am the Son of God? If I do not perform my Father's works, do not believe me. But if I perform them, even if you do not believe me, believe the works, so that you may realize and understand that the Father is in me, and I am in the Father. Then they tried again to arrest him, but he escaped from their power. He went back across the Jordan to the place where John first baptized, and there he remained. Many came to him and said, John performed no sign, but everything John said about this man was true. And many there began to believe in him. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Diyos na may naagahan sa ito na Diyos. My dear graduates, how are you this morning? Very well. You look very nice, I must say. You look so different than every day. Of course, this is a very special day, a day of gratitude to the Lord for all that the Lord has given to you. Medyo mainito, no? But you're wearing. Don't worry, we are also suffering with you. Today, let us reflect on Scripture as we prepare for Holy Week. As you know, on Sunday, it will be Palm Sunday. We will be reflecting, the readings will be helping us to prepare for that most important event of the church calendar. Let me begin by saying, just 3 days ago, March 24, marked the 35th anniversary of the assassination of Archbishop Oscar Romero of El Salvador. He is to be beatified this May, having been declared martyr for the faith. Who was Oscar Romero? What was he known for? I wonder if you have seen the video Romero. If you have not, I think you are missing half of your life. So during Holy Week, I suggest you look for a copy and watch the movie Romero. Romero was the archbishop who stood up to the repression of the U.S. military backed regime that killed thousands of innocent lives in El Salvador in the 70s and 80s. Amidst the repression and violence, Romero could only offer his weekly homilies over radio, assuring the people that no matter what, the Church of the Poor will live on. Listen what he said to one of his speeches. If someday they take away the radio station from us, if they don't let us speak, if they kill all the priests and the bishop too, and you are left a people without priests, each one of you must become God's microphone. Each one of you must become a prophet. On the day before his death, Romero walked into the fire by challenging an army of peasants whose leaders feared and hated his reputation. Ending his long homily, he said this, Brothers, you are from the same people. You kill your fellow peasant. No soldier is obliged to obey an order that is contrary to the will of God. There followed a thunderous applause. He was inviting the army to mutiny. Then his voice burst. In the name of God, then, in the name of this suffering people, I ask you, I beg you, I command you, in the name of God, stop the repression. The following day, Archbishop Oscar Romero was assassinated while celebrating Mass. Those who follow the right path will surely encounter opposition like Christ did, and even then. Our readings for today's liturgy move us closer to Holy Week, the celebration of the Passion, Death, and Resurrection of Jesus Christ. The readings heighten the intense conflict brewing between those who choose the right path as against those who wield power, authority, religious or civil. In the first reading of the book of the prophet Jeremiah, the enemies of the prophet are denouncing him and plotting to murder him. Why? Jeremiah was speaking the truth about the idolatry and rampant corruption in the house of Israel. He denounced the worship of other gods, the greed and the corruption of both prophets and priests, of both rich and poor. Speaking in behalf of Yahweh, he commands them to deal justly with their neighbor, not to oppress the orphan, the widow, the foreigner, and no longer shed innocent blood. Jeremiah demanded reform of the present oppressive situation. In the Gospel today of St. John, the Jews were ready to stone and to kill Jesus. Why? Jesus spoke the truth of his being the Son of God, who has inaugurated the new kingdom of peace and justice. He proclaimed his kingdom in word and deed. In word, he spoke of God's mercy and compassion to the sinner, to the marginalized in society, the prostitutes, tax collectors, children and orphans, widows and foreigners. He proclaimed a kingdom not based on wealth, prestige or power, but in humble service to the needs of society. Indeed, he proclaimed the kingdom through healing the sick, raising the dead to life, expelling demons, forgiving the sins of his people. Jesus demanded reform of their lives, leading to the transformation of society into the image of God's kingdom. My dear graduates, my fellow believers, we ask ourselves today, do we wish and choose to do the right thing? Maybe in the somewhat ordinariness of our lives here, in the same haven of the university, are there situations inviting us to witness in truth and courage to the gospel? Being simply honest, for example, to our parents when we go out with friends, where we will go, or when they call us on the phone. Being courageous to say no to a best friend who desperately wants us to help him cheat in the exams. Or rather, to read the whole article of the book we summarized, I resort to copying summaries that are not my own. While we may not find ourselves yet, in dramatic life-death decisions, are we prepared to face them when the time comes? Like athletes training for the Olympics, the big moment does not happen automatically in the final event. It happens gradually in the everyday honing of skills, practicing routine exercises, strengthening mental endurance that one can overcome the seemingly impossible odds of winning the Olympic event. Finally, when we are confronted with seemingly insurmountable odds and challenges in life and death situations, can we still do the right thing? My dear graduates, I pray and hope that your training here in the Ateneo de Nava University has painstakingly imbued in you the discipline and fortitude not only to stand up for the truth and to resist evil, but also to aggressively pursue justice, especially to the least in our society, even unto sacrificing your own very lives as Jesus did.
Thank you.
this our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice of your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
Grant, O merciful God, that we may be worthy to serve ever fittingly at your altars, and there be saved by constant participation through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, and Eternal God. For you have given your children a sacred time for the renewing and purifying of their hearts, that free from disordered affections, they may so deal with the things of this passing world as to hold rather to the things that eternally endure. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we praise you as without end we acclaim. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. On the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said a blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and giving you thanks, he said a blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the cup of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Sacrificial victim, by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in you.
May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Saint Joseph, her most chaste spouse, with the blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and Saint Ignatius of Loyola, Saint Francis Xavier, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help.
May the sacrifice of our reconciliation betray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. May this confirming faith and charity, your pilgrim church on earth, your servant Francis our Pope, and Rolando our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and their entire people that pray for your hope. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom we have summoned before. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world.
To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory of your Son, forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign. Blessed are we, who are called to share in the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy to be shed to the Lamb, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you.
these memories.
Let us pray. May the unfailing protection of the sacrifice we have received never leave us, O Lord, and may it always guide far from us all that would do us harm. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen. The graduates will now say the Thanksgiving prayer and pledge to the graduates. Graduates, please remain standing while the rest please be seated.
Thanksgiving prayer and pledge of the graduates. Please repeat after. Lord Jesus,
Lord Jesus,
our teacher and master,
our teacher and master,
we praise and thank you,
we praise and thank you,
for the gifts of body and spirit,
for the gifts of body and spirit,
mind
and heart,
life and love,
life and love.
We thank you for our parents,
we thank you for our parents,
teachers, classmates and friends, who have accompanied us in our days at the Ateneo.
Send us your Holy Spirit,
that we may learn more each day about you. The human person and society. And the wonders and richness of your creation. Give us the knowledge and skills we need to serve you.
The church.
And our neighbor.
Teach us to be generous.
To serve you as you deserve. To give and not to count the cost. To toil and not to seek for rest.
To labor and not to ask for reward.
Stay glad of knowing that we are doing your most holy will.
Make each one of us aware.
That my Ateneo education cannot be for myself alone.
In great part.
It is a trust to me.
For my family.
My school.
My people and my God.
Relying on your grace.
We humbly respond to this trust.
We pledge to develop our minds and expand our hearts.
To acquire knowledge and competence.
And to be rooted in the values of your gospel. We pledge to be men and women for others. Dedicated to the service of the Church and our society. As we leave the halls of the Ateneo, we pledge in a special way to give ourselves to the development of people and our people. Amen.
Let us all stand and sing the Thanksgiving song.
Thank you.
now bless these diplomas and medals, and make water a symbol of life and reminder of our baptism. These signs of life and work here in the Ateneo remind our graduates of the ideals embodied in the school motto, Primum Rendum Dei, and their role as men and women for others, who should give of their lives for the service of the Church and nation. I therefore bless these diplomas and medals in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
The graduates will now sing their graduation song. Graduates, please remain standing for the rest of the evening.
I have what it takes to hold on. I am ready.
God's blessing. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.